We got it rolling.
So, here we go. So, to add to the plate, 400,000, 2,000, I think. And we got 150. These are just Harbor Freight generic diamond plate. Probably won't last long. Put them in a little base so they don't slide around on me. Let me put an end on it so that I can use it up against the face of the workbench. But I think I'm gonna cut this down because I noticed that when you try to work a chisel on there, you know, you're basically at the end. So having that 1 inch of plywood right there isn't very conducive for trying to hit the face of the chisel. So, with that being said, those two items, the beginning, and we got some leather. So here's the leather from Hobby Lobby. 3 pounds, farmer's bundle, large 3 pounds, $9.99. They used a 40% off coupon from Retail Me Not, so it came to $6.47. Not bad for a huge bag of leather. So let's see what all is in. I really only need a strip like 4 inches wide by 8 inches tall, but I figured for $6.50, let's give it a shot and see what all is in there. Look at that. There's a lot of stuff in there. That's thick too. So this is a remnant bag, so who knows what I may end up with here. I mean, that I could square up and use that right there by itself. Little strip. Couple more little strips. I mean, it's definitely varying lengths and varying pieces. I'll probably end up with a lot of that. But who knows? I mean, I suppose you could get strips for like a sheath for the thread. You could probably use that for that sort of stuff. That one's pretty solid. See, that's ultimately what I want. Something like that right there for my sharpening station. Because it's nice and thick and it's solid. A lot of this is just going to be used for strips. There's a good one. Nice brown one. Love that smell. See, something like that could work. Square it up, put a rectangle. But ultimately, that face one, this one right here, was the one I had my eyeball on for the piece. 4x8 is the goal. That's 6 and a quarter. That one might not work. But I'm pretty sure there's, oh no, that one's got a stamp out of it. Right there. That one looks pretty used and abused right there, actually. There's a nice piece right there. That one would work perfectly. Basically, all I'm going to do is just adhere. Oh, that one's thick. That one's really thick compared to the other ones. That one's pretty thin. That one's a good one right there. I'd be able to get 3 inches all the way down. 3x6, maybe? I don't know. I like that one right there. That one's pretty decent. That one's a thinner piece though. I don't know, out of all the stuff that I'm getting here, I just need to make a choice on which one I'm gonna use. I guess match up the colors with themselves too. Oh was hoping this one was, I noticed this one in the store. Turned out to be a little bit rattier than I thought, but I was hoping it would be a full rectangle. Oh well, that's the chance you take. Oh yeah, here's a really nice one right there. That's nice and thick too. And that's really all the vigor I need. It's the same thing, same stuff. Same with that right there. That one's kind of cut up. Nice thick. That's the thick stuff right there. I mean, that's a little thinner. I mean, if you're using that, you know, and shining your chisels, I mean, that's plenty right there. And the only other thing would be the length. That's the longest one that I have, and that still works. So, and if one of them doesn't work as well as the others, I could always swap it out and use a different piece and compare them to one another. A couple more diamonds. Another thin piece there. Hello. Just a few more.
I'm going to play.
There's a piece of string. Where are you going to play?
Abby's house.
Abby's house. Where's your watch? And you're going to want a jacket. It's really cold out right now. By 6 or 7. A couple more slivers there. It's nice and thick. So there's definitely, there's a circle punched out. I wonder what that was for. Two of them. Another couple of slivers. So definitely a piece that will work for what I want it to. Several pieces. I just need to make a choice on which one I'm actually going to use. But for $6 to get all of this, that's not a bad deal. If you ask me. So, pretty good size stack. Ooh, I like that one right there. I think this one might be the one. I think I'm just going to square it up. Biggest rectangle I can out of there. Slap it on a piece of plywood. Just like this. Then I can put it in the vise and use that as my final finish. Yeah, that's perfect. Just need to make sure I make it big enough for a plain blade. This one here, it's only 1.5 inches. So most, the widest chisel or thing that I have is 1.5 inches right now. So if I go 3 inches, I think I'm good. I think I got that covered. God, that one's good too. I don't know yet. I'll sort through it and figure it out. Then we'll do an update after I'm done, or maybe during. I don't know yet. Still new to this videotaping my projects. So, the intention here, this is my workbench right now. Right now I've got this big old hoss, an old entertainment center that we're getting rid of. Snowblower, drill press, sink. Got some organizing to do in here, but that thing's got to go right there. Because that is where the carpenter's bench is going to go. 2 foot by 6 foot, right there in the middle. And that's going to be my stage for everything. There's all the leather. There's the other pieces of leather. Plenty to work with. Plenty of extra. Plenty of other things. So I'm going to go back and watch a couple of Wrangle Stars videos. I think he made a couple of sheaths for different tools at some point. And I'm going to see if I can figure out what I can use. I'm probably going to end up going back to Hobby Lobby at some point and get more leather too if I get into this. So that's a start. Talk to you later.